You shouldn't care about what other people think. And that means you gotta keep on keeping it on. But for whatever reason, that's just so damn difficult to do. Hey guys, it's Brian, and today's topic is a really good one. I'm sure there are some people in your circle that you know that have this inherent ability to just not give a damn. And they just do whatever they want to do or say whatever they want to say. But for the rest of us, it's not as easy, nor does it feel natural. But I have some very good news for you, and that is it's learnable. It just takes the right mindset, a little bit of courage, and probably some mistakes along the way as you fine-tune the art of not giving a damn. Let's break it down. Sure, there are people that truly don't give a damn. They'll lift their shirts up in front of a camera, maybe light up a car on fire just because everyone else is doing it, or maybe just not show up for work because, well, they don't give a fuck. But we need to establish the difference between not giving a damn versus not giving a damn about yourself. If you don't give a damn about yourself, well, you're gonna do stupid things that's gonna hurt you in the long run. Do you wanna be the guy that's smoking weed after an exhausting day of work, shoving pizza down your throat in front of a TV, and rationalizing all of that as, I don't give a crap? Or do you wanna be the person that takes control of your life, wants to control your destiny, and starts a business regardless of what your friends or family say? You see, there's a good version and a bad version of not giving a damn. And the concept of not caring about what others think only works if it's to justify bettering yourself, making yourself into a stronger, more intellectual, better version of yourself. So if that means changing your lifestyle, maybe you want to exercise or update your fashion and look good, and your friends hold you back, either they make fun of you for that or look at you weird or judge you, you want to ignore them. The next thing you need to realize is that the majority of people around you don't really pay any attention to you because you're just so into themselves. Yeah, they might notice you for a second, but unless you're doing something really weird to maintain that attention, they'll just be back to their own business in no time. So here's the thinking. Growing up over the years, we've learned that there are consequences to our actions. We've either been made fun of, rewarded, praised, punished, looked at weird, or judged. The point is that we've been socially conditioned to maximize the good consequences and minimize the negative ones. It's absolutely normal, and this is really why we care about what other people think about us. But here's the thing, everyone else has gone through the exact same experience, so they're really focused in on themselves and pay very little attention to you. Now, it's very important to surround yourself with people that will support you to do your thing as well as encourage you. It means your current circle of friends don't support you. That might mean ditching them or minimizing the time you spend with them and also creating new circle of friends. Now, I know the concept of dropping your friends seems a little bit scary, but guys, the payoff is huge. Not only will they support you in your growth and development, but there's other factors that are at play here. In particular, there's going to be less drama, you're going to sleep well at night, you're going to have stimulating conversations, and your days will just flow better. People that support you will respect your time as well. So they'll show up when they say they're going to be there, and they're not going to flake out on you. And overall, they will respect you. Moving on. To the outside observer, there's no difference between not giving a damn versus looking like you don't give a damn. That's right. Fake it till you make it. Now, this might seem obvious and easy to do, but really it's a matter of faking it well enough. And that takes practice so that you get all the non-verbal and behavioral cues just right. Which reminds me of a video on the way that gives you some body language pointers as to how to present yourself as a confident person. Don't miss it. The next thing you need to do is to learn how to laugh at yourself, as well as how to diffuse situations when things get a little bit awkward or a little bit weird. Now, I remember back in the day, I would wear this really bright pink blazer. It was a great way for me to differentiate myself from all the other guys that were just wearing their standard black or dark colored clothing. So I'm talking to these two ladies at the table, and this guy walks over, and in an effort to impress the girls, he tries to shoot me down. He looks at my jacket and he says, "Hey, are you gay?" And I respond in a very jokingly way. Tragically for you, buddy, I'm not. Now, of course, I thought it was funny at the time, and the girls definitely got a kick out of it, and the guy just ended up walking away. But I remembered in that moment, there was this initial urge to defend myself and say, oh, I'm not gay or something along those lines. But then I realized, why do I care what this guy thinks? So instead, I just kind of laughed at the situation and made light of it and said what I said. As you become a better version of yourself, there are going to be people that want to shoot you down or kind of test you. And really, it's up to you as to how you want to handle that type of situation. And it really comes down to this ability to laugh at yourself or to diffuse an awkward situation in a very friendly and socially acceptable and fun way. It does take a little bit of practice and putting yourself in that type of situation a number of times before you really get a good handle of it. And the beautiful part is that once you realize you can handle whatever people throw at you or whatever gets in your way, you're liberated to really not give a damn because you just don't care. And whatever situation, whatever happens, you can handle it. Now, as an exercise, I'd invite you to do something that forces you to be in a situation where you just can't give a damn. And that means doing something that opposes the status quo. Stand when others are sitting, sit when others are standing. Maybe next time you find yourself in an elevator, instead of facing the door, face the people. You'll quickly realize that no one really cares about what you're doing anyway, and nothing bad really ever happens. Now, a final thought to leave you with: every morning the sun rises, and every evening the sun sets. The sun gives us life, it brings us warmth, it helps plants grow. At the same time, it can make places completely unbearable, unlivable, even gives us skin cancer. But the sun doesn't rise or doesn't set because we want it to, or because it helps us, or because it hurts us. The sun rises and the sun sets because it just does its thing, and so should you. So if you want to work with me personally or send me a question so I can answer them in a future video just like this, go to my website, 101mentoring.com. Guys, thank you again for watching, and I'll see you next time.